What do you have to say to persons who claim that you are promoting defamation online?
Oh, that is a blatant lie. That is propaganda being spread by those who are upset that the bill has gotten so much opposition. They're trying to change the story. They're trying to change the rhetoric. They're making the issue that people who oppose the bill, they want license to say anything. They believe that freedom of expression is freedom of expression to say anything. That is a lie. That has never been my position. I am for responsible speech. What I am against is the criminalizing of speech that is not criminal. Okay? So even in the case of defamation, where it is wrong for a person to publish lies against you, and I agree with that, it is wrong. I am saying we already have a civil court where a person can go and get redress in the form of compensation. They can get fines paid to them for the defamation. But they are saying put them in jail if they can't pay. And I want to repeat this argument here. You can choose any civil matter. Any civil matter, whether it is suing for some defective thing that you bought in a store or whatever. You can take any civil matter and apply that foolish man or straw argument. You can say, what if the person can't pay the fine, the compensation? What should we do then? Turn our entire civil court into a criminal court? It can't work. What they're doing, they're taking one extreme example where, oh, a man might be set up to defame you over and over and he don't have money to pay. Taking one extreme example to try to apply it to the other 99% of cases. And that is wrong. It can't work. I have said for defamation, if a man can't pay, let him be ordered to apologize in the same space where he published his defamation so people can see he's a liar. There was a court judgment against him. That will take care of the defamation. It will go away. If that man wants to repeatedly lie, people will know by then that he's a liar, because they will see that you have to go and apologize over and over. People will know you're a liar and not to take you seriously, and that defamation can't do you anything. You see?
What about the argument the Prime Minister used when he says if it falls into disuse, it's not an argument to say we should not bring criminal defamation in the cyber bill?
And he goes on to say, my response is very important here, because he goes on to say why you can't use that argument. He gives the example of buggery that we have in our law, and he says, oh well, the buggery law has fallen into disuse, should we say we should move it? And he referred to my argument where I told him, no, buggery is not a right, it's not the same thing. Buggery is not a God-given right in the way freedom of expression is. And he basically ridicules my argument by saying, look, the judge in Belize just rule and say it is a right. Well, look, even the judge in Belize is wrong. Listen to me. From the time a child comes out of the womb, the first thing you get from them is a cry. They have a naturally God-given, free-born freedom of expression. But no child is born buggering another. It's a different thing. Buggery is a choice a person makes. Okay? They use their freedom of movement to move their body to have sex in a certain way called buggery. That is not the same as a fundamental freedom. So you can't argue that we should take off, we shouldn't remove criminal defamation because it has fallen into disuse, because we shouldn't remove buggery even though it's fallen into disuse. It is a foolish argument. Prime Minister needs to come better than that. He knows better than that, because when he brought it up in select committee, I showed him. And so he's using those things, they are using those things to blind people's eyes to the real truth. Plus, Vincentians need to ask themselves, what is your Prime Minister really saying to you? Is he saying that we should consider moving the buggery law because a judge has ruled that it is against people's rights to have it there? You should ask yourself that question.